Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This week I am still playing Grishoalbrand because I believe this is what I'm going to be playing in Pittsburgh this weekend. So after reading the comments on my last video, obviously I made a lot of mistakes because I had very little experience with the deck. I think I played like two or three matches before recording. So obviously I made mistakes, and I really appreciated the comments on my misplays. So mainly the one thing I wasn't thinking about, which cost me games and could cost me a game in the future as well, was that I can move to discard step with 8 cards in hand and discard my Grishoalbrand. This is something that would have been really good in many of the games I played last week in the video. So like, it's not that I thought it was bad or anything, I just simply didn't think about it at all. So this week, hopefully in the video, I'll be thinking about it and moving to discard step a lot more. Especially with the rituals and Simeon Spared guy, like, it usually doesn't cost you a lot to just move to discard step, because Gore's Vengeance only costs 2 mana to cast. So yeah. That's a lot, a big thing that I learned. So this week, the only change that I made in the list is I added 2 Time of Needs. This is a recommendation from my friend Ben Friedman, who's been playing the deck quite a bit. He likes the Time of Need because obviously this deck is way worse when you don't draw Grishoalbrand. So this is like Grishoalbrand 5 and 6. The other change, so basically what I cut to put them was 1 Metamorphos and 1 Borborgimos. So from the difference from my list last week was basically I cut 1 Metamorphos because, so I went from 3 to 2, then I added a second Tormenting Voice, and now I only have 1 Metamorphos because I cut it for Time of Need. So basically I think Metamorphos is strictly the worst card in deck. It's not needed until you actually combo, and then you need to Goryo's Vengeance with no manas and tap. So it's like, it's very situational, and basically you only really need one in your deck. So which is why I am down to 1 now. Also, I went up 1 Tormenting Voice because I wanted an extra card to discard my Grishoalbrand, since I have now more ways to find it with Time of Need. And yeah, it's pretty much what I changed. I changed the mana base, obviously. So I cut 2 Swamps. I cut a Blood Crypt for a Vogon Tomb, and I added Polluted Deltas, 2 extra Polluted Deltas. That's pretty much it. And the sideboard, I added Angers. The reason I added Angers over Pyroclasm is that I expect Zoo to be popular this weekend. It was very popular. By Zoo, I mean like Wild Neck Cattle decks, so Burn and Zoo decks. They were played a lot in Brazil for the GP. It's the most recent GP, so I expect the resurgence of Wild Neck Cattle decks. And this is why I expect Anger to be a little bit better in Pyroclasm and those matchups. The rest hasn't changed. Yeah, also I cut 1 Borborygmos because I really felt like the second one was not needed. In most cases I was able to just through the breach a World Spine Worm and then kill my opponent. So Borborygmos was not needed. It might have happened too often, because one of the mistakes I made was basically in most of my matches, I should have been attacking first with my Grishoalbrand rather than going off and then attacking after only if I need it. That was because I wanted to keep the option of just World Spining a worm into play, a World Spine Worm into play with Through the Breach, and so I didn't. So I still have an attack step. So I guess some, like in the perfect scenario, you don't have to attack with Grishoalbrand first. But I think realistically I should have been attacking with it first, which would remove the option of being able to kill with the World Spine Worm. But still, since we added Time of Needs, I can fetch my Borboring Mouse. So I figured having only one should be okay. I guess we'll find out. Like, it might be wrong, especially since I'm planning on attacking a little bit more before combat. And like, so basically, if I want to play the Borboring Mouse, if I want a time of need for Borboring Mouse, I need green mana. So I'm probably gonna need to mana morphose. And then if I want to discard it, I'm gonna need a Faithless Looting. Yeah, I guess that seems a little bit unrealistic because I also need black mana for Chorus Vengeance if I plan on discarding it. Otherwise, if I want a Time of Need plus Rooted Breach, I most likely need 6 mana because it's 2 plus 4 for Splice onto, like, let's say, a Nourishing Troll. Yeah, that might actually be a mistake. Okay, let's put it back. Let's put it back and then remove a Tormenting Voice. Yeah, okay. Let's try that. Yeah, sorry about it. I thought it through, but I think it makes more sense that way now. Okay, so we have a second one. And the rest is, the rest is the same. So I'm gonna be playing 2 mans, again, because 8 mans fire very not consistently. And basically, I found that actually the competitiveness in 2 mans have been pretty much the same as in 2 mans. Like, I'm not playing against burn every round, and so I've been liking the competitiveness in 2 mans so far. So it's especially good when I'm trying decks I'm not sure if they're actually good, I'm not sure if the time on needs are actually good, so I don't want to risk too many play points. So anyways, stay tuned, and I'll be joining this 2 man right away.